Hello and welcome to a 3v3 cast on Argus Desert Gate. Starting off, we have Colette playing as the Brother Captain. We have DDSASAS playing as the Plague Champion, and like the previous cast match, you're just going to refer to him as Das because that is just much easier than having to spell out his entire name. And in the bottom lane, we have Soysen playing as the Force Commander. For Red Team, we have Morgan MLG Man playing against Soysen in the bottom lane as the Warlock. Freeman in mid as the Lord Commissar up against Das, and Adilla in the top up against Colette, although top and mid will probably be combined together to form a bit of a 2v2, and already a bit of action going in here between the Farseer and some Inquisitorial Stormtroopers. Stormtroopers going to kite away that Farseer, doing a lot of burst per salvo, but not having that much DPS overall as a squad. Both Eldar players building some Banshees here as well for Red Team. Meanwhile, in bottom, the Warlock going to be fighting some scouts in ranged combat. Scouts not behind any green cover will probably lose to the Warlock overall. Scouts not really doing that much damage. Warlock actually does quite a bit of damage in range. I believe it's somewhere between 14 and 16 DPS. I'm not actually sure on the full value, but already some grouping going up in the top side as the contestant's VP is not actually captured by either team just yet. Brother Captain coming in here could actually use Weird Hammer to actually increase the damage resistance of nearby units and increase the speed of them as well. Guardsman and the Sentinel are going to be pushing forward. The Sentinel upgrade has already come in. No one is capping that VP even though there's plenty of units nearby. Everyone is just getting ready for a fight. Some Guardsmen getting executed by the Lord Commissar, going to give that a 100% damage boost. Heretics coming in here from the side out in the open. Do need to be a bit careful. They're a little bit exposed right now. Brother Captain going to be charging in here with that power sword of his, actually doing power melee, one of only two commanders to actually do power melee with a default weapon. The other person is the Chaos Lord. And Brother Captain is actually going to get forced away here, taking a lot of damage. Will actually go down overall. He's on your 15 HP, 10 HP. We'll run through some terrain and we'll be able to get into a shot blocker, or using this as a shot blocker, and we'll be able to get out of that combat zone. Meanwhile, in bottom, it looks like it's just been a bit of a standoff between both players, but Red Team still pushing in through top. Red Team now in control of that contested VP. Banshee's going to be coming in here for Adilla, could actually guide the Banshees to do a lot of damage on retreat. Heretics retreats away. CSM going to get caught out by these Banshees here, but it looks like Grenade Launcher Heretics or Grenade Launcher IST could actually do a Grenade Barrage to try and save them, but the Heretics are going to get away. The Banshees are going to get forced off. The Sentinel taking a lot of damage. Gain some emergency repairs here by some Guardsmen. These Grenade Launcher IST doing so much damage to the Guardsmen, all grouped up so close together. Sentinel going to get away there with 29 HP. And the IST very low here, down to 80 HP, but still on 4 models. The IST and Strike Squad going to be coming in from the south, or from the north, sorry, against Adilla's Double Dire Avengers. Both gain up. Upgraded as well to the aspects of the Avengers, so we could see some retreat grenades from Adilla. Meanwhile, in bottom, Tactical Marines going to be pushing up against here. The Force Commander is trying to Synix to these Tactical Marines, waiting for the Banshees to come in, and here they come. Battlecry is on cooldown, or is not actually getting used. It is getting used right now, but the Channeling Runes here from the Warlock. You need to knock over that Warlock in order to cancel Channeling Runes' ability, and Soysen going to have his Tactical Marines and Scouts forced off here. The Force Commander is also going to get forced off very soon as well. Banshee's actually going to try and kite the Force Commander around instead. Meanwhile, top, some more action still going on. This engagement has been going on for so long. Grenade Launcher IST still in this fight. Going to get hit by some Rangers before retreating away. And that Force Commander is going to go down. Banshees with their power melee, it's just going to be a bit too much for that Force Commander to handle in retreat, and you do get that Sync Killer as well. The enemy is capturing one of our strategic points. Entire Purgation has been purchased here for Colette. Raptors for Das. Adilla going for Rangers. Freeman not with a tier 1.5 unit yet. I think he's actually bought upgrade instead. He's bought a Power Sword on the Lord Commissar and stomped on the Sentinel, but he's actually getting a heavy weapons team right now. Meanwhile, Morgan getting a Guardian Weapons team for bottom lane. Did actually spend some power on those Channeling Runes, which you saw earlier in the previous engagement. Double CSM going to be pushing forward. Purgation is ready. Going to be burning down this Webway Gate here of Adilla's. And bomb, Force Commander still lays dead on the ground. ASM going to be jumping in. One model is jumping in a little bit delayed, in fact actually dies mid-air, which is kind of odd looking when you see a dead ASM model flying through the sky. Warlock going to be tying up these Tactical Marines in melee combat. Tactical Marines actually going to be forcing melee onto the Dire Avengers instead, which is a really nice choice. Going to get a couple of models, but do need to be careful in case they actually lose any models of their own Dire Avengers. I do are not worth the same as Tactical Marine models. However, taking down two models, Guardian Weapons team is setting up, and Tactical Marines are going to get forced off here. Dire Avengers barely getting away with 49 HP. Meanwhile, top, the action continues. Grenades getting thrown onto these Tactical Marines with the Kinetic Pulse, a very nice combo there by Adil, doing some nice damage to these Tactical CSM, not Tacticals, but to these CSM Dire Avengers, and range is going to be backing away. Banshee's going to be fleeting in here. Heavy Weapons team now set up, can see the scream onto the double CSM to actually suppress them. Purgation though, going to be doing so much damage here. Even doing friendly fire damage, actually slowing friendly units, I believe, with that ability. Double grenade launcher IST going to be coming in here. The Farseer again trying to tie up some units. Raptors jump in for DAS, unsupported, but going to be enough to force off that heavy weapons team. Some repairs onto that Sentinel. Rangers coming back in for the fight though. Could get some shots onto these Raptors, which currently stand out in the open, and the Farseer will get forced off in the end. Guardsmen with flamers in mid though here for Freeman. Lord, the Lord Comps are going to be burning down that power node, and also red team in control of that VP as well, giving them a 2-1 cap. Blue team though still ahead in VPs overall at 483. Guardsmen extremely low, going to be forced out of there. Raptors still in the engagement, and blue team pushing all the way to the base of red team right now. Rangers going to get some shots. Dire Avengers fleeting forward. No grenade available for them, but it looks like they do have enough energy for it. Wow, look at the damage that they're taking, down to 10 HP. Woo. Get away barely there with 2 HP. Purgation even pushing forward as well against the Sentinel. Entire generator farm though is in risk. Colette, I think, could have used the Purgation squad to just burn down the entire generator farm rather than trying to push again even further forward, since they are already pretty much outside of red team's base. Double ASM here in bottom lane for Soysin, which is an interesting choice against the Warlock. Some Spirit Stones though at the very last second. They're actually going to heal up the heavy weapons team, and actually going to let them live. Farseer, excellent support commander, going to be healing up with that last second heal that actually protects Freeman's heavy weapons team. And blue team starting to tech up to tier 2. Colette and Das both taking up now. Soysin probably going to be quite a while before he techs up to tier 2, given that he went from double ASM. That's 100 power on just ASM, on top of other upgrades such as scouts with a shotgun upgrade and the sergeant. That's an extra 40 power right there. Raptors though jumping into combat. Sentinel going to be stomping them. Rangers barely out of range here. Do have that Pathfinder war gear trying to stealth and trying to infiltrate there. The Raptors are going to get forced away here. The double grenade launcher IST doing some grenade barrages as well. One Raptor model is going to go down. Dire Avengers trying to position here for a grenade by the looks of it, but they're not going to get one in time. But could always flank the rest of the units here. The double IST and the Purgation as well. Farseer though going to be running away still. Dire Avengers going to be sitting behind some green cover, and red team starting to regain control of their natural generator farm. The Purgation just doing so much damage. The grenade combo and the Purgation's damage is just going to be so much combined. Dire Avengers barely getting away there. 20 HP this time. Purgation model actually going to go down here to some Ranger fire by the looks of it. Their weapons team is also trying to suppress the army here of the Grey Knights, but grenade launcher IST going to be doing some decent damage here from range over the grenade barrages and cooldown. Comms are also going to kill a model or two on retreat here, and it looks like they're going to get forced off in the end. And these flaming guardsmen the whole time have actually been burning down the entire generator farm here of blue team, and blue team will have to repurchase right away. Red team getting their generator farm back up though. Meanwhile in bottom, just even more action going on in this game. Banshees could go down here to these ASM. ASM could actually jump once again as well to finish them off, but not even needed. They will actually be able to do so without it. Warlock going to be running away here. Double ASM going to be pushing forward here for Soysin. Could see a flamer purchase on these Tactical Marines, although Soysin really needs tech ups tier 2, so I'd actually not get that flamer upgrade, so scratch that idea. Everyone else tier 2 except for Soysin. He's just spent so much power in tier 1 that he's actually really far behind right now. He's also got upgrades on the Force Commander, the Artificer's Armor, and the Iron Halo. That's an extra 45 power on top of the Scouts, on top of the double ASM as well. Like champion in mid as well, going to get thrown or going to get forced off here by these double grenades as well. And in top, Raps is going to be jumping in. They do have the aspiring champion leading them as well, going to have that power fist, very good at picking up models, very good at single targets as well, such as commanders or sub commanders. Soysin able to take down two generators in the bomb side before Morgan is able to actually come back in here and react to double ASM though. Do need to be a bit careful. That one ASM squad in particular, very low on health, and the Merciless Witchblade on Morgan MLG man is very effective at picking off models, doing 130 damage per hit, also draining energy. And look at that grenade barrage there, two grenade barrages going to be knocking over those guardsmen. And heavy weapons team upgrade with the refractor shield, an excellent choice against the grenade barrage. lead model cannot be knocked over, so it means grenade barrage doesn't actually do anything. You can try and damage them and try and kill the lead model, but even still, the Refract Shield does also give a 50% damage or range damage resistance as well against range damage. Banshees are going to be going in for the Purgation Squad. Colette going to be forced off here. Das is moving in through mid and is currently going to be facing two with Colette now off the field. We have Soysen moving towards the mid area as well. Double Dire Avengers moving in from bottom. Going to be firing away at some scouts here. 363 VPs to 328 here of red team. Raptors though could jump in here, or need to jump in here, needs to suppress the army. Banshees though going to be fighting Raptors. Raptors will lose against the Banshees, especially with the Farseer supporting them. You can see the Raptors actually jumping away, losing a model against these Banshees. Banshees not even losing a model actually, which is quite surprising against the Raptors, especially with the Aspiring Champion. Grenade's going to get thrown down. Das going to be retreats away. The grenade actually going to do friendly fire damage to the Farseer there in the end, out of everything there. Nemesis Vortex actually going to be forcing the Guardsman Squad away. Flare going to get dropped down onto the army here. Freeman does not want to retreat. His Lord Commissar is going to try and run away here, but the flare range is only going to be so much. Or actually, all these units are still getting affected by the flare, which is quite surprising. Meanwhile, these tactical CSM, or tactical space marines, sorry, in bottom getting hit by some Dark Reapers here. Do need to retreat away here for Soysen. ASM looks like they've destroyed the wall by using the jump to destroy the wall. Channeling runes onto the Banshees once again, but the Banshees aren't actually in any combat whatsoever. Banshees going to be jumped onto the ASMs now, and Soysen does need to be careful. That special from the Force Commander going to be knocking the model away, but these ASMs are still going to go down, I would imagine. 1 HP, yep, they're definitely going to go down. Warlock also upgraded with the Witchblade Akernus instead of the Merciless Witchblade. Witchblade Akernus doing 71 power melee DPS, also having the Ethereal Slash ability, extremely strong against heavy infantry with that 71 power melee DPS, and also the Ethereal Slash doing a lot of disruption and also doing melee damage as well. Very effective. Not as effective against heavy infantry or more high mod health models, but very effective nonetheless. Rover Captain running through mid, the entire army here of Das going to be pushing through here. Meanwhile, red team, or Freeman in particular, actually going to be taking down Generator Farm once again, and Colette going in for a Grey Knight Dreadnought in bottom. The Banshees actually pushing against Generator Farm. Shotgun Scouts coming in once again, Tactical Marines coming in to push. Banshees going to be pulling away, and Morgan does need to be careful here because Das is coming in from behind. Destructor going to go down onto these Shotgun Scouts. And here comes the Chaos Army here, double CSM, but both of them unupgraded, which is kind of an odd build actually. Normally do see the double Mark of Zinc upgrade coming in here, and looks like it's going to be a full retreat here for Morgan. But there is a melee Dreadnought here, it's going to be picking off some models, also going to be landing a special here as well. Heretics coming in as well onto the retreat path as well, but all the squads will live overall. Sentinel going to go down to that Assault Cannon, or it's not Assault Cannon, it's Heavy Bolter Dreadnought. I think it's actually called. The Commissar going to be running away here. Stubbornness bonus, not really getting any better given that he's actually by himself. I don't even know if it actually gets. I think he needs at least one troop next to him for the stubbornness to actually work. But the Brother Captain going in a bit aggressive there alone will be going down, and the double IST do need to start repairing up this Grey Knight Dreadnought because it's actually very low right now. And that last cannon is pointing towards that Dreadnought. There's nothing to actually interrupt this last cannon as of yet. Dreadnought looks like it might be able to barely get out of range. Nope, it will go down. The IST went in time to actually repair it, or didn't repair it enough. The heavy weapons team last cannon doing so much damage. Banshees though going to run into a friendly grenade, and they will be able to barely get away, but the grenades were very briskly timed there for Morgan. ASM going to be jumping in. Wraith Lord is going to meet these ASM, and if the Wraith Lord lands a special, these ASM really are going to be in a lot of trouble. The Sergeant at the very back there could lose a model. The Guy Ranger is going to be forced inside the gate. Shotgun Scouts and that Thunderhammer Force Command are going to be a bit too much. We have a Noxious Cloud going on top onto that last cannon. Heavy Weapons Team Ranger is going to be forced off. The Dreadnought in Blood Rage mode, uncontrollable right now. The Heavy Weapons Team inside the bunker, or the Guardian Weapons Team inside the bunker, is going to get forced off. That was a Heavy Weapons Team inside the bunker. Commissar is coming in. Guardsman executed as well. Farseer also on the scene as well. Raptors have been given energy here by the Strike Squad Justica. Very nice use, actually. Raptors is very reliant on energy, so it's a very nice idea to actually use your Strike Squad Justicas to grant them energy. But currently, nothing to counter this Dreadnought, as the last cannon heavy weapons team has been forced off. Raptors, though, fighting the Power Sword Lord Commissar here, and Gravity Blade on the Farseer going to be lifting up quite a few units. Raptors going to be jumping away from that Commissar. Commissar going to be running away from that Blood Rage Dreadnought as well. Heretics coming in for some worship support. Classic and get 4 stuff in the end. Could go down to the Dreadnought, 200 HP Dreadnought doing 100 heavy melee DPS. CSM going to be forcing off these guardsmen as well, and the Dreadnought still doing what it wants to do as well. Nearly level 2, might actually go up to level 2. The Farseer inside of this bunker, or the Commissar inside this bunker, actually going to get killed by the Purgation here. Dreadnought level 2 now. Needs to be a bit careful though, it's going in a bit aggressively. Heavy melee Banshees coming in here, or the heavy melee Exarch on the Banshees is purchased. Guardsman going to be going down here for Freeman. Banshees still not the most effective time of the Dreadnought, but is keeping it occupied while the last kind of heavy weapons team does set up in Guardsman. And that is a bit of a mistake to actually go into Blood Rage mode, I think, while the heavy weapons team has got a firing arc on you. Dire Avengers though pushing in, could see some grenades onto the CSM. Grenades are getting thrown onto the Purgation on retreat. 2 grenades will be enough to bring the Purgation squad down very low, but not actually enough to finish it off. And that is also going to be a dead Dreadnought, and we also got a bit of a weird graphical effect going on with the Dark Reapers. Shrike squad also going to get forced off. Heretics also forced to pull away here. And Soysen pushing in through mid, and Morgan is going to meet him in mid, armed with the Wraith Lord, armed with the Double Dire Avengers here. Brother Capson still remains dead on the ground right now. Play Champion wasn't able to push forward enough with the rest of the army up top to actually get res onto the Brother Capson there. But a last cannon is set up here though for Soysen, so that Wraith Lord is going to be forced to back away. P-Devs though set up, that could be a really nasty P-Dev shot, is going to catch out both the Dire Avengers here. Dire Avengers need to pull back behind a wall or behind some terrain and actually hide there and start repairing up this Wraith Lord. Back to full health, P-Dev shot falling slightly short there. Banshee Exarch still down for the count here for Morgan, MLG man. Banshees though pushing in with the Dire Avengers and some Flaming Guardsmen here. Looks like they want to take down the entire blue team's generator farm. The double IST pulling back, trying to sit defensively. Strike Squad going to be coming in. Purgation going to be following up soon. Strike Squad using the slow onto the Farseer, drains 40 energy and also slows the Farseer by 80% for 4 seconds. And Psychic Storm onto the IST, very nice use. If the IST do retreat away, they will take bonus damage since it does do power melee. This IST squad is probably going to go down completely here. And, well, they're still alive, but Dire Avengers on retreat path. And the Strike Squad could also die as well due to some grenades. All the grenades going to go down slightly prematurely. It's a bit weird to throw the grenades when there is elevation differences there. IST going to be running away here, and Dire Avengers are going to fall back away from those base turrets. Freeman able to take down the generator farm, but blue team grouping in mid, both Das and Soysen going to be grouping together, and Morgan is trying to hold the force on his own but taking a very defensive stance because he can't really do too much about two players in mid. Warlock though pushing forward, Deacon going to be coming out, double CSM going to be pushing in, and red team could come in for a big flank here on mid. So blue team will need to be careful, Soysen will need to be careful on his positioning because he might need to help Das out in a second here. Warlock taking a lot of damage from the Plague Champion and double CSM. P-Dev set up in a position to actually defend in case of an incoming flank here. Farseer going to be using the Time Field, the armor of the Assyrian. Both players, or in fact most players now tier 3 actually, the only player not tier 3 is currently Soysen. Farseer going to be tied with those Devastators, Colette coming in as well from behind, coming in to flank the flank. Strike Squad going to be fighting the Farseer. The Farseer might even go down here completely. She is going to definitely go down here. Flare going to get dropped onto the armies here. But the Fist of Rockets here for Freeman. Nunchuck fall onto the Guardsman. And the Guardsman going to be retreating away here. Freeman's Commissar does need to be careful. The stubbornness bonus isn't going to last forever with his Guardsman retreating away. Banshees also getting tied up here. Banshees might even go down. The Stormfield is on. Chaos Predator coming in. Banshees definitely are going to go down here, I'd imagine. It's 26 HP. They will actually live. Very nice Ethereal Slash, although it's slightly too early. Raptors do have knockback immunity after they jump in for a couple of seconds or a second or two. Same with ASM, same with all jump units, I believe. So you do need to actually wait or be slightly patient when doing that, although the Ethereal Slash still doing full damage. The Predator's also been upgraded as well to the Mark of Zinc. Very nice for chasing down that Wraith Lord. The Mark of Zinc Predator actually having a Twin-Link Glass Cannon as its main weapon, and should chase down this Wraith Lord. Meanwhile in Bossum, Shotgun Scouts meleeing a Guardian Weapons team here. That's going to be a dead Wraith Lord. One more hit, although the Predator is not focusing down that Wraith Lord, it's actually focusing down something else. One more hit though, it should actually take down this Wraith Lord, and it will go down. The repairs are not going to be in time. Raptors though very aggressively here. The Aspiring Champion still alive is going to go and fall down to the Lord Commissar. The Lord Commissar has actually stopped focusing down the Chaos Raptors, instead focusing down that Predator. Predator will go down, but these Raptors though running through here. 10 HP, the Aspiring Champion leading the Raptors will go down, and that's going to be a dead Raptor squad. Farseer has come alive once again, very low though, 130 HP, level 5 though. does need to be careful and does seem to fall back. Guardsman executed here by the Commissar, and again some more weird graphical glitches going on with the plasma gun. You can actually see these white lines for some reason. Devastators though going to be setting up for Soysen in top. Colette is pushing with a small force with a strike squad and purgation squad. Terminators have been called in here as well for Colette, armed with an incinerator here, very effective against the guardsmen of Freeman's, or the lots of high model low health units here of red team anyway. Elder as well, the incinerator will be effective against them. Morgan pushing in from bomb. Force Commander's Iron Halo about to run out, does have that Thunderhammer, does have that Artifice Armor. Battle Cry not going to be available since there is no energy whatsoever, and PDEV's going to be hitting those Banshees. Banshees actually forced away very early here. No Exarch on them, and actually taking a lot of damage in range, and Chaos Terminators called in here for DAS. Double Devastator set up, one regular, one Plasma. And the Strike Squad Terminator Army is going to be coming down. Dilla's Banshees do need to be a bit careful here. The Exarch gets sniped before they even have a chance to react, and the Banshees will get forced off and might even go down overall. The Purgation was trying to do a bash by itself, but is actually going to get forced off here. That is still going to be a dead Banshee squad for Adilla, pushing in a little bit too far. Purgation squad will live, Plague Champion will live, Strike Squad is coming up, and the Terminators are also coming up as well. Soysen coming up with the Force Commander and some Tactical Marines. The Incinerator doing a lot of AoE damage. All the units in this area unable to be affected by abilities, and I believe that also grants friendly units energy regen. But the Incinerator Terminator is going to be chasing down this last cannon heavy weapons team. Avatar going to be coming out for Adilla. Adilla actually down to just double Dire Avengers here as well. Fire Prism going to be coming out for Morgan, M1G Man, Nunshaw 4 activated once again. Needs to focus down that Lord Commissar. In fact, Lord Commissar is extremely low and retreating away. So Nunshaw 4 is no longer activated here. Marker Corn CSM going to be coming in here. Very interesting to upgrade to double Marker Corn CSM this late in the game. And Soysen going to be capturing that bunker with the Force Commander and retreating his Force Commander away. I don't know if that was a slight mistake or not. Meanwhile, Red Team, or Morgan in specific, is actually going to be trying to push in mid with a small force of two Dire Avengers and a Warlock. Blue Team going to be placing down a generator farm in mid since they were unable to hold the top generator farm for so long, although they now are placing down a generator farm on top as well. Terminators and Marker Corn CSM going to be bashing down this generator farm. A lot of power melee there with all those units. ASM's going to be jumping in, that's going to be a dead Dire Avengers squad, 74 HP, although not getting focused down in melee or in retreats. They're going to be focusing down that second squad. It will still go down. The second squad looks like it'll be able to barely get away. Warlock trying to do what he can against these ASM, that Witchblade Akernus. He also has the Providence armor as well, although I think Providence is on cooldown. I'm not actually sure about that though. If he's going to use Providence, he needs to use it now. But it's actually going to retreat away, and I think that the Warlock will go down here. There's just so much rage damage, so much blue flame coming in here. And Blue Team going to be in control of the top side map. Red Team needs to group up and push through mid. By the looks of it now, the Chaos Terminators upgraded with the Autocannon as well. Autocannon was changed in the most recent patch, so its range was actually reduced, so it's in line with the Storm Bolters. Terminator is going to be going in here, but the armor of the Asurian for the Farseer going to be activating that time field. The Avatar coming in, Fire Prism also coming in as well. Guardsman and the Commissar look like they're both being forced away here, and a Baneblade going to be coming out here for Freeman. Avatar though going to be fighting his Marker Corn CSM, and the Commissar is actually not retreating away. He's still armed with that Fist of Brock, is going to be taking down a couple of Marker of Corn models here. Wailing Doom going to go off, actually going to catch out some retreating CSM. No, it's not, barely going to catch out some retreating CSM. They move so quickly. Noxious Cloud going to be going down onto the heavy weapons team here. Freeman, Colette still pushing in. Singularity going to be going off. The Gravity Blade looked like it went off as well for the Farseer, but didn't actually hit anything in particular. Avatar though going to be forcing off that Strike Squad. A model is going to go down here. That Avatar doing 240 heavy melee damage per swing with that sword. Very effective at picking up model. Look at that health that it just took away from the Plague Champion there. Plague Champion level 3, no upgrades on the Plague Champion either. But the Avatar doing so much damage with a single hit, but last cannons and PDEVs are set up. The Dire Avengers here avoiding that initial PDEV shot. Force Commander might need to go in. Plasma Grenade is going to get thrown onto that Devastator squad, going to be forcing them away. PDEV's going to be landing a shotgun to force away the Dire Avengers. Vanguard veterans here for Soysen. Another Wailing Doom going to be landing onto that PDEV squad. Another last cannon also set up, but the Avatar just outside the Arc of Fire here. We'll be walking into the Arc of Fire now, but the Devastators are repositioning the Chaos Terminators with this Autocannon as well, trying to do what they can. Purgation, no upgrade on them yet. They should upgrade to the Psycannons at this point in the game, so they can actually do some damage to the Avatar and Baneblade with the Psycannons, since they do explosive damage. which is the same type of damage as auto cannons. Baneblade though pushing in, the Marker Corn CSM pushing in as well. The Force Commander with that Thunder Hammer is actually going to be doing some decent damage to the Avatar, although you actually want him to be focusing down the melee, well not the melee blob, but the ranged blob as well, since it does do AoE effects instead. Terminators as well, Guardsmen gain very low, but Nunshell Fall is activated. I'm not sure these Guardsmen are in range of the Nunshell Fall, and especially getting knocked away by that Wailing Doom as well. And Orbsman Bahamut are going to be going down as well. D-Cannon going to be running into one of the beams here as a strike squad, or is that Interceptors? Interceptor squad is actually going to force him to run in there, and the D-Cannon will go down. Heavy Weapons team just sitting there with 11 HP, looks like he might get meleeed down by some Interceptors here. Very low at 13 HP, the Interceptor's throwing a grenade onto the Dire Avengers, going to be doing a lot of damage. That looked like it was an anti-vehicle grenade. An Eldritch Storm going to be going off as well here, as and Vanguard's going to be fighting Banshees, another Mark of Zine Chaos Predator as well. Vanguard's going to be jumping onto a Fire Prism, although they don't actually have any AV. I think the Interceptors have actually gone down, or the Interceptors are teleported away and run away. Banshee is going to be retreating somewhere. The Interceptor should be able to make it out of there alive at 40 HP. Nothing else on the retreat path unless the Warlock is going to fight them as well, but the Warlock is retreating away as well. 124 VPs to 119. Red team going to go in for a cap onto the top side of the map. Brother Capson going to be forcing off the Lord Commissar here, level 5 Commissar. Brother Captain's armed with the Nemesis Force Sword as well. I don't know if he was armed on that earlier or not, but I've only just noticed that. He did spend a lot of the game on the ground though. But some Shotgun Scouts going to be coming in here for Soy Sin. Level 3, very close to level 4. One more model loss or for the enemy team would have caused them to level up to level 4. That said, they're going to get forced away before they're able to do too much damage here. And Blue Team look like they're going to be pushing in together in for the top VP, thinking it might be a bit easier for them to capture. 110 VPs for Blue Team, 119 for Red Team. VPs are very close right now. Sea Account's going to be getting built here for Morgan MLG Man. And that could be a Rocket Run. It is a Rocket Run. Rocket Run looks like it's going to get dodged for the most part, although the rest of the units here for Das going to get caught out. Some dead Heretics there. Well, Heretics will live, but some Heretic models will definitely go down. Still no upgrade on the Purgation squad though. But the Purgation though, doing some nice AoE damage. I still think the Psy Cannon upgrade would be coming in really handy here. Strike Squad going to try and force melee onto this group. We have a call-in here as well, could be a drop pod here for Soy Sin. It's actually going to be Paladin call-in here for Colette. Marco Korn CSM also trying to tie up these Guardsmen. The Paladin's getting knocked back quite far away. Gravity Blade going to be lifting up these double Marco Korn CSM combined with the Wailing Doom. Very nice combination paired by Adila, but the Gravity Blade was slightly too early. That's going to be throwing away those Marker Corn CSM. Vanguard Veteran's going to be jumping in here for Soy Sin. Guardsman very low, but Nunshell Fall still activated there on that Commissar. Was still extremely low. The Heavy Weapons team barely living there. Still all these units. Nunshell Fall no longer activated. Marker Corn CSM could actually kill this Guardsman squad in retreat, and they actually will do. Vanguard Veteran's going to be jumping even further forward here. That could also be a dead Avatar. Vanguard Veterans could turn and face these Guardsmen here as well. Plasma still having that weird bug where they have massive white lines. Banshees and Sea Accounts going to be fighting this Whirlwind. That Whirlwind is going to get killed as well. Sea Accounts with a lot of power melee. Banshee with a heavy melee. Exile Paladin is teleporting in very aggressively here to try and finish off the Avatar. Avatar will get finished before it's able to actually finish casting its ability. And the Vanguard Veterans kind of just suppressed locked here. By the looks of it, needs to retreat away before they take too much damage here. 96 VPs, 102. They start to retreat away now. And Morgan MLG Man is going to get in control of mid, while Blue Team getting control of top. Blue Team needing to push in through mid, and Soy Sin coming back out of base once again, going to be pushing in, trying to reclaim that natural interceptor zone. Going to be throwing a melter bomb or a crack grenade onto that fire prism, but not able to actually finish the job off. Brother Captain's coming in here. Nemesis Vortex going to be knocking back some Banshees, but Brother Captain unable to actually fight a Sea Accounts on Banshees by himself. Some Shotgun Scouts going to be pushing in, going to try and throw a grenade maybe before the Emperor could actually finish off the Fire Prism if well placed and if it actually hits. Grenade is going to get thrown, it is actually going to take down that Fire Prism. Grenades were boosted, buffed in the most recent patch to actually do bonus damage against vehicles now. And there's a very nice Eldritch Storm here from presumably Morgan MLG Man, going to be taking down Devastator Squad. Surprisingly only taking down one Devastator Squad, they're very grouped up and I thought it might take down a multiple. Distort Field onto the Sea Accounts, not going to be enough to protect them from the amount of range fire here that they're taking. Another Eldritch this time I believe from Adila. Going to be killing these Chaos Terminators here, also killing, or nearly killing, some retreating scouts. Will kill some retreating scouts. In fact, the Tactical Marine's going to be surviving, though, with 2 HP. A Autark also getting called in as well, but the grenades are going to miss. The Autark coming in from Morgan M1G mount looks like it might go and capture. Meanwhile, on top, Nunshot Falls still activating. Paladins still wailing away at that Lord Commissar, but the stubbornness bonus is going to be a bit too much, and everything retreats away now. The Heavy Weapons team will go down. When the Commissar does retreat, Nunshot Falls does stop working. Force Command going to be coming in mid, going to try and knock off that Autark. 74 VPs to 102. Battlecry is activated, knocking back that Autark multiple times here. Wraithguard going to be pushing in through top here for Blue Team. Blue Team placing down a Shrine as well, so Dask and everyone else can actually reinforce their units. P-Devs also set up onto the VP. Once again, Last Cannon Devastator is going to be pushing in forward. Autark armed with an Executioner is going to be backing away here. Wraithguard, though, needs to be a bit careful. They're very slow right now and are going to get tied up by that Strike Squad if not careful. Still a dead commander or dead plague champion in mid there. Soysen gonna be pushing him, that Force Commander. I'm surprised the commanders aren't all like level 10 at this point. There's just been so much action throughout this entire game. Nemesis Vortex getting dropped up here onto the Dire Avenger. Force Commander getting lifted up by the Gravity Blade. Nemesis Vortex gonna be following that Dire Avenger squad very closely here, and will explode, doing quite a bit of damage. Singularity is also going to go off. Meanwhile, on top, a Bane Blade here for Freeman once again. Meanwhile, in mid, Blue Team still trying to push in. Interceptors teleporting in once again, or teleporting out rather. Brav Caps going to go in for a res onto the Plague Champion. And we have a Manticore Strike or a Flare and Emperor's Wrath coming in here onto that Mark of Nurgle Shrine. Colette going to be pushing him and the rest of his forces, although it looks like he's a bit hesitant to actually do so. Paladin's going to be going in here. It's Demolisher Cannon going to be destroying that Purgation and Strike Squad here. Paladin's going to be going into melee now. The Mark of Zinc Predator going to be focusing down that Baneblade, but does need to be careful. It is very low itself. There's no repair support. Interceptors could actually throw a crack grenade onto the Baneblade as well. Paladins needs to focus down that Lord Commissar since Nunshot 4 is still activated. Chaos Terminator is also going to be coming in here. Red Team going to be sending some reinforcements. Dire Avengers and a Farseer. Fire Prism here for Adilla as well. Shockwave going to be going to be destroying some guardsmen here. Nunshot 4 was no longer activated. Those guardsmen go absolutely ruined by that ability there. Intercept is going to be able to barely escape here. 20 HP. Baneblade going to be trying to push in forward. The Paladin is going to be teleporting away to safety. Strike Squad going to get caught out by a grenade here from Adilla. The Chaos Terminator is pushing extremely aggressively. He needs to teleport away as well. Double Mark of Zinc Predators. Baneblade will need to be careful pushing in against that much AV. Morgan still pushing through mid against Soysen. 74 VPs to 71. Seer Counts going to be jumping in onto these Tactical Marines. Banshees going to get forced off by that Thunder Hammer. Force Commander going to be losing an extra model as well, but the Seer Council auto combo is going to be a bit much. But Colette coming in here with a Purgation Squad. Red Team are able to actually push in through top as well right now. Autark taking a bit of damage, but going to type that Purgation Squad. Grenade Barrage doing a little bit of friendly knockback as well, but keeping the Seer Council in check. The Seer Council going to be leaping into combat with that Autark as well. So much power melee damage here. The Autark and Seer Council doing over 250 power melee combined, which is only amplified by the fact that the Seer Council are level 4 as well, doing even more damage. Land Raider 4, but I suppose actually just two Mark of Zinc Predators coming in. That is a very dead P-Dev squad. Seer Council and Autark going to be forced away. Some regular Terminators here for Soysen, and Seer Council going to be jumping in onto that Force Commander. Battlecry is unavailable right now. Red Team still in control of top right now. That Force Commander is definitely going to go down if not careful. There's just so much damage on retreats here. He will go down, but the Seer Council and Autark will get forced off completely here. Brother Caps are going to be pushing through mid, only to be met by Freeman's Guardsman, Heavy Weapons Team, Last Cannon, and also a Bright Lance Weapons Team as well. The Brother Caps are going to be taking too much damage, going to get forced off in the end here. Dire Avengers on tree with Adilla's Farseer guiding some Dire Avengers, going to be taking them down along with a Fire Prism with a long range shot. Terminator is going to get caught out here by the Armored Asurian, the Time Field ability. Interceptors coming in here as well, going to be throwing a grenade onto that Farseer, but it looks like it's going to be game. Blue Team unable to actually push in time. 7 VPs, 6 VPs, Emperor's Wrath going to be coming down here, although it's not actually going to hit anything. But the Interceptors, Terminators not going to be in time to actually get a decap onto any of the VPs, and the Red Team are going to take this game.